Hey guys, welcome back. I am going to try this again. I am going to do keep. I'm going to try to do the What Sold videos and actually keep up with them. Sometimes it's just so hard to do it. Film other videos, eBay, the real job, and have a family. So, but I'm going to try to stick to a little bit of a schedule and try to just do it every couple days and post them as bonus videos for you guys. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to do this a little bit differently than I was before. I'm going to show two items at a time and tell you a little bit about them. Not much. I'm going to keep these videos a little bit short. All these items sold on May 26th and May 27th as of this time. Some might still sell afterwards. But so the first two items, and I'm going to show them to you right now. So the first two items are, let me fix my chair a little bit. Got a new computer chair down here, so we're feeling good. So the first item was a Russell Wilson's Seattle Seahawks blue jersey. It was a medium jersey, a kid's jersey, sold for $5.99. We picked this up at the local thrift store. Don't have much into it, maybe a buck. And when I picked it up, Russell was in the news a lot because he wanted out of Seattle, and I was actually thinking it might have moved a little bit more and faster, but it didn't. But so we've had this for a little bit. Not upset for what the price it went for. I'm glad it's out of here. So the other item was the Red Heart Super Saver yarn, Dark Sage. I picked this up at the bin. I think I showed it in one of the videos. It got $8.99 plus shipping. I think it only weighed maybe 8 ounces or something like that. So it went out. So that was a really good pickup, especially at the bins. $1.29 a pound, can't beat it. The next two items was a Homedics replacement HEPA type air filter. I got this in the bulk liquidation box, as you saw in the previous video. So I only have like $1.50 some into each item out of the two boxes. We got $12.99 plus shipping for that filter, so that went out. The other item was a Hobico Deluxe Heat Gun, 1,000. Now, I just recently picked this up at a local estate sale. The video went up the other day, or maybe yesterday. I'm not sure now. I was going to keep it. I think I only paid $2 or $3 for this heat gun. I was going to keep it, but after I noticed that they sell, I was like, well, I really don't need it, so I'm going to get rid of it. So we got $18.99 plus shipping on that. The next two items was the Yu-Gi-Oh! The Movie VHS. We picked this up at a yard sale, paid 50 cents for each VHS, we paid 50 cents for each VHS tape. So I had ended up having two of these. I still have one more left, so we got $3.24 plus shipping. And I ended up sending that regular mail only because medium mail is slow, and it really wasn't that much more to send it first class. So I think the buyer will be happy that I did that. The other item, it's an Apple iPod Shuffle, 1 gig, silver, untested. I don't have iTunes, so there was no way for me to test it. It did have the charger. We picked this up, and I don't think I did a video on it. We've had an auction buy where I got that and an old VHS camera. It took the mini disc. So I think I had $45 into this and the camera. So we got $17.25 out of that plus shipping. And I think the camera is about to sell. We've had a couple people ask about it. So definitely going to make our money on that. The next two items. Vintage Lennox Symphony China 11-inch footed centerpiece bowl with 24-karat gold rim. We picked this up at a moving sale. Definitely didn't make much on this. I thought we were going to make way more. We probably only made $2 on it, I think. Maybe a little bit more, but it wasn't much. I thought these things went for way more than they did, but they don't. So stay away from that, maybe. But maybe it'll sell better for you. I'm not sure. The other item, picked this up at the local estate sale where I picked up the heat gun also. It was a vintage General Electric AM/FM radio. I got to look back at the video because I think I paid $5 for it, maybe even less. But I came home, tested it, it worked. I didn't test the batteries. I only tested it plugged into the wall, and it worked. So ended up getting $40 plus shipping. So that was a really good flip, and I've only had it less than a week and got it out of here. So It's pretty good. The next two items. Camelback charcoal orange water bottle. We picked this up at one of our last thrift store runs. We didn't pay much on it. We didn't make much on it, but it's out of here. So I think it was only here about 2 weeks. Somebody made an offer on it. I maybe probably could have held out and maybe got the full asking price, which I think was only $6.99. But we got $6 plus shipping, so the buyer will be happy it was brand new. Another item that we showed. Danbury Mint Penn State Nittany Lions Christmas Sleigh. Yinzer mom actually found these earlier this year, right after Christmas. Somebody had the sleigh, Mrs. Claus, and Santa Claus. They came with certificates of authenticity, the original boxes with the styrofoam packing, everything. These things looked brand new, probably just displayed in their house. So we bought all three, $20 a piece. We listed them, nothing. They wouldn't sell. There was no offers. There was no watchers. So in the last month or so, I pulled them down off of eBay. And just last night, I relisted them. I said, you know what? I'm going to relist them now. We'll see what happens. So we got an offer on the sleigh. Me and the buyer went back and forth. We finally agreed to $42 plus shipping, which we're happy with. I mean, that basically pays for two of them. And we still have the Mrs. Claus and Santa. So that was a nice little flip, quick flip. The last two items for this video was a men's Levi's 550 relaxed fit tapered leg blue jeans. We've got a whole bunch, not a whole bunch, maybe four pairs, all brand new with tags. And I think we paid $1 to $3 a pair. So, and I knew they were gonna move. I couldn't pass it up. So we picked these up, got an offer today, right before I went to the post office for $20 plus shipping, accepted, buyer paid. I was able to ship them today. So the buyer was probably thinking they were gonna go out tomorrow. The buyer's gonna get them a day early, which is nice. So I think those were going to Idaho. I think that's where it was, Idaho or Iowa, one of the two. So that was a nice little one. The other item was a Victor Photographic Products Vintage Floodlight. I purchased this light before I even started YouTube videos. I got a huge bulk buy of a bunch of photography equipment and stuff that the person ended up throwing in a bunch of extra stuff on top of what I actually wanted. And we pretty much have sold through everything. We have a couple books left that we still have listed that were photography books, vintage ones from the 1940s and 50s. But the main bulk stuff is gone. And let's just say we did really well with it. I wish I can come across another one of these because just the stuff it was in there just sold so fast. And for, I mean, $200-$300 an item. And I think we paid $100 for the lot. And plus the stuff the lady threw in on top was selling for $50 to $100 an item that I didn't even know I was getting until I got there. She's like, here, just take it. So we did really well on that. I actually kind of feel bad about that one still to this day after looking at a couple of the books we have left. So I lowered the price on this light just to get rid of it because I don't want it to sit around here. I'd rather somebody actually get it, use it, display it, whatever they're going to do. So, but that's the What Sold video for today. I'm going to try to keep the What Sold video short and to the point. I want to try to get it out to see if there's stuff get that you can see, hey, what's this stuff selling for? Now, granted, it might sell for different prices wherever you live compared to where we're at, but that's okay. It might keep you might go out there and say, man, you know what? Yinzer found this and actually sold it pretty quick or whatnot, or man, he got this, but he didn't sell it for much, so I might pass on this. Hey, we're all in this together. We're out here trying to help each other out and trying to educate everybody. I learned from you guys. And you guys learn from me. So it's all a big community and some of us try to help each other out. So, but until next time, guys, remember like, share, and subscribe. Remember our video for our giveaway is up. You have until Saturday night, midnight Eastern to enter. And then we're going to pull a winner on Sunday and either do a video Sunday or Monday and announce that. Probably be Sunday though. Probably Sunday evening. We'll announce the winner of the camera. And we'll ship it for free. So Till next time, guys, remember, like, share, and subscribing. Keep picking. Bye.